In this video today, we're going to cover using the Lucity import and update tool to import data from the Wincan suite of software. So today what we'll work with are TV inspections and TV inspection observations. To do that, we're going to go ahead and open the Lucity import and update tool like I've got here. You can open that from the bin folder of your install directory. I've got a shortcut on my desktop that I use to open it up. So I've got the program opened up. I'm going to go ahead and expand it out. And what we're going to look for is we need to find the templates for Wincan for our observations and our inspections. So I'm going to hit the down arrow next to our plus sign. We're going to add a template at this point. So I'm going to scroll all the way to the bottom. And I have choices here for a Wincan for sewer pipe TV inspection, sewer pipe TV inspection observations, sewer pipes and sewer structures. You can import the update. You can update the data for structures and pipes. However, we're not going to talk about that today. Today, all we're going to cover is TV inspection and TV inspection observations. So I'm going to select TV inspection. I'll go ahead and hold my control key down and select TV inspection observations and hit load. Now on yours, your tool at this point, you probably have one of two listed at the top. I have 20 of 21 because of our test environment. Either way, that's going to be just fine. We're going to go ahead and make some modifications to begin with to both templates because the stock templates that you have, you can't do anything with. So the first thing I want to do is select my pencil, and I want to change the name of my import. And I'm going to go ahead and just delete the sewer pipe TV and leave us with Wincan inspection. And I'm going to hit save. And I'll hit OK on this. And this begins the process of creating and setting up your own template. As I said, the stock templates that come with this, you can't actually do anything with. You have to create your own version. You have to rename it and save it. So we've created this now called Wincan Inspection, and this will be here whenever you open this program. So you can make modifications to this as you want moving forward. There's a number of ways that can be done, and I'll show you some ways that you can do that as we go through. So I want to be able to do that for my observations. So I'm going to go ahead and edit it. I'm going to get rid of that part. I'm going to be left with Wincan observations, and I'm going to go ahead and save that. I'm going to hit OK. So the first thing we'll talk about after that is we have a grouping name and a grouping order for both of these. 3 and 4 is our grouping order. Our grouping name is called Wincan Sewer. You'd have 1 and 2 if you loaded in the structures and the pipes. But as I said, since we're not going to discuss that, we just have 3 and 4. And that's going to allow us to bulk import just inspections and the observations that go with them. So I'm going to go ahead and move to the Data Source tab. We've got some options inside of this. The first is we have to have a data source to be able to do anything. So again, I'm going to click on my pencil to edit this. I'm going to browse for a data source. In this case, I'm going to hit the browse next to the database, and I'm going to choose my Wincan access file. I'm going to open it up, and then I'm going to hit OK. Now you'll see that instead of being grayed out, our SQL select statement now is available actually to edit if you want to. I'm going to hit save again on that. We'll save that information. It's going to ask if we want to pass that data source that we just selected to the rest of the others in the group configuration. We're going to say yes to that. We want to be able to use that same data source across all of these inspection tool, these import tools that we've got. I can now look at the mapping for this. And we'll see that we've got a number of basic fields set up. I'm showing a number of defaults. The property, the table, and the fields are being shown. Value is something that's probably not defaulted to you, and the way you get to that is to just right-click anywhere in this group. You can then uncheck or check items to be able to see them. I've unchecked the mask and the caption, and in turn I have checked value. The value basically just shows us the first record in the list of what's being pulled. I can double click on the dividers. Whoops. I can double click on the dividers and be able to show the MPEGs, or in this case, the full data values that are being brought over from the table itself. So this is what we get for Wincan inspection. Our correlations tab is empty. There's a set of correlations that you can make. You can say I have a certain property, I have a certain value, and my import value equals that. It's another way to be able to transpose data that you can bring from the table. Obviously, that can also be changed using the SQL statement, or you can change it in the mapping like we've done with our case statements across our formulas. I'm going to go ahead and select our observations tab, and you'll notice the exact same thing. We passed that data source over right here. And so now in our mapping, here are all of our items that we're mapping across this that we're going to pull out of the Wincan information, and we're going to pass it into Lucity. Couple of things that I'd like to draw forth is we're going to go back to our inspection. This property right here, we're actually grabbing the document path for the MPEG files out of the table itself. If you've backed up your video and photographs that you've taken from Wincan, if you've backed them up to a different location and would prefer it to be referenced from that location as opposed to the default location that Wincan allows us to see, then you're going to want to change this case statement to indicate the area where, to indicate the drive that you've got, where the videos and photos are being stored. If you haven't done that, if you're okay with the default directory, then we can leave this the way it is, because we're going to create links to all of your media straight out of this import process. Go back to our observations, and we'll see the exact same thing that we have here too. So again, if we're pointing to a different place, then we need to change those case statements. Once we're okay with both of these, looks like our mapping is good, we're going to go ahead and import this data. So we're going to have to start from our inspection screen, and I can come up to import. Now I can import these individually just by clicking the import button, but if I want to group everything together, I want to hit this down arrow, and we're going to import as a group at this point. And this does a couple of things for us. One, we're going to be able to see all of the data that we're going to import, and two, it's going to actually group everything together. We're going to do all of these inspections first, and then we'll import all of the observations automatically. We don't have to manually drive that process. So the import review screen shows up. We've checked that box on the general tab to be able to review the data that we're going to bring in. If there's a problem with your data, if there's a problem with the import process, there's going to be a big red exclamation point that shows up here in the invalid reason box, and also here. It would indicate what the problem is. Problems can be fixed from this screen if they're just basically data typos or differences in different data types across the fields themselves. In this case, we don't have any errors. I'm going to hit continue, and it's going to import that record. Our transfer is complete for our inspection, and I'm going to hit OK, and it's now going to automatically do two things. We've gone actually to our observations tab, and now we're processing the records for that, and you'll see on our review we have a problem. And I'm going to go ahead and stretch this box out a little bit so we can see better. We're going to pull our field over, and it says that our defect code is not correct. So our defect code tab is here, or I should say our field is here, and I can change this just by double clicking in it, and I bet that was to be a C. So I'm going to go ahead and put a C in its place, and I'm going to hit retry, and it's going to process our records again. So our review screen has come up, and it's showing that we have an issue. The red exclamation point here and the red exclamation point here indicate that we've got a bad piece of data, and it says that our defect code is not correct. Probably an extra letter. I'm going to go ahead and take that out, and then I'm going to click on retry, and it's going to cycle through the records again, verifying that all of them are okay, we hope, and they are okay at this point. So our error is gone. I'm going to go ahead and click on continue. And now it's going to finish processing those records. I'm going to hit OK. And if we go to our web version, here is our record. In fact, I'm going to refresh that. And here's our new inspection record. In fact, it has the most recent inspection date checked now. There's our televised date on it. If I hit our plus sign and expand this, we've got 8 observations that go with it. I can click on it and expand and see that our observations are all listed. If I highlight one of them, we can see that in our table we apparently did not have observations come over for them. Must not have had any in the table. But if I come back out to the actual inspection, we can see that the letter, instead of being white, is now orange. I can click on it, and it will show that here's the MPEG file. That would be the file name and the description of it. This would be the MPEG file showing you where it is, that it's attached. We can actually click on it to open it and then view it at that point. I'm going to close out of that. I'm going to roll our observations back up at this point. And this concludes our video on importing TV inspections and observations through Wincan. Thanks for watching.